Good morning, students. In today's class, I have discussed about action verbs. See, there is no difference in verbs or action verbs or the doing words or the action words as well. They all are similar. So, action verbs are the verbs, words which used to tell us what our noun is doing. So before understanding this action verb, what we need, we had to understand what is a noun. So students, already I have given you lots of explanation about these naming words or noun. Again I am repeating it, a noun is a name of person, place or thing. Now what does a verb do? Action verbs are verbs that tell you what exactly the nouns are doing, or the doer is doing, or the subject is doing. See, subject, all of you know, can be a noun or a pronoun. So action verbs used to tell us what the subject is doing, what is our action, what is the action performed by the noun. See, you can see here there are pictures of a baby sleeping on a bed, boys are fighting, the chef is baking a cake. So now these three words, sleep, fight, bake, all are just giving us, explaining us or conveying the action done by these nouns like baby, the chef and the boys. So sleep, fight, bake are here action words or the doing words, or it is also known as verbs. See, verbs are the same which are called doing words or action words, or you can say action words are commonly known as verb. Now some more example of verbs are plays, dances, reads. And again you can see here several pictures. A lady is cooking, someone is diving, a girl is playing, the boys are painting the wall. So now these all, cook, dive, paint, play, are the action done by these nouns. So moving away, you can see here a boy is having his lunch, so eating. He is eating something. So the action done in this figure is, the action word or the verb is eat. Now this boy is drinking water. So now drinking is the action performed by this word. The word will be drink. Now here you can see Mino is talking with Dino. So the action performed by these, both of these nouns are talk. Again you can see here there are several pictures like eat, swim, study, sing and brush. Now here you can see the definition also. Word which tells us what people, animals or things do are called doing words or verbs or action words. Now moving away. Okay. Words which tells us that what people, animals or things do are called doing words or verbs. As these verbs show an action, they are also called action words. Not just because all these words, those who are the doing words or the verbs, used to tell the action performed by the subject or the doer. That's why it is also known as action words. See, verbs used to perform different functions like verb performs, some verbs, there are lots of verbs, obviously there must be lots of doing words. So some verbs show the action of the subject, some of the verbs link the subject to the noun or the adjective in the predicate. As all of you know, or among coming classes I will discuss about the sentence and the subject and predicate, then you are going to understand predicate. Till now, just only know that a sentence consists of two parts, that is subject and the second one is the predicate part. So subject is always having noun and pronoun, whereas the predicate will consist of verb and other parts of speech. Now verb performs different functions. Some verbs show the action of the subject, link the subject to the noun or adjective in the predicate, work as helping verbs with main verbs. Suppose if my main verb is playing, then is, If I used to tell that I am playing, then am will be the helping verb which is used before the main verb. Now action words or action verbs tells what subject of a sentence does. I already told you that the sentences consist of two parts. One is subject and the second is the predicate part. Subject always used to have a noun, whereas verbs always come to the predicate. So action words or action verbs tells what a subject of sentence does. Now about types of verbs. See, in class 3 there is nothing need, I don't think it's necessary to know the details of types of verb, but for your introduction with these, I am going to give you the names of types of verbs. I haven't mentioned the explanations regarding this, but the types of verbs are intransitive verb, transitive verb, compound verb, helping verb, or the helping verbs are also known as auxiliary verbs, linking verb, regular verb, or irregular verbs. Now, again, the action words that tells what we are doing are verbs. A definition is, this definition is a little bit complicated. Just only remind that all the words which used to tell what the people, animal are doing, or the subject is doing, or the doer is doing, is known as verbs. Now after this explanations, I have discussed a bit of your practice book worksheet, which is right now I'm going to do. The major thing which is mentioned in your practice book is, one second. Okay, here we go. So if you used to open your practice book, the first thing which you are going to read is a few lines have been written for a subject, that is Amit. So I'm going to read it first, then I will explain it, which is necessary to explain you before we should attempt the worksheets. So Amit is a talented boy. He makes beautiful paintings, writes poetry, and sings songs. He even acts in the school plays. Now children, you can see here the action words used for Amit is makes, writes, sings, and one more is acts. Now you can think what is the common thing in these action verb, use of s. What is the common thing is use of s. All the action words are having s at their end. What does mean? These are plurals. No students, just remember, while we are making any sentence and we are using verbs in it, then if our subject, that could be a noun or a pronoun, is singular, what the subject, the noun or pronoun of the sentence is, if it is singular in number, then all the verbs will be used in the sentence by adding s. We have to add s with the verb. When a subject is singular in number, I'm repeating it again, listen it carefully and try to understand. See, if your subject is singular in number, then definitely when you are using or making a sentence with using a verb, that verb must have s at the end. S at the end with the verb, not with the noun. If our noun is singular, like suppose Amit is a singular number, and the verbs, all you can see, all the words are having s at their end. So in the same way, when your subject is singular, then you have to add s in the verb. While if the subject is plural, like children, teachers, doctors, people, then if you are using a verb with them, you should definitely avoid using s. That means the verb will not have s. Now considering this, now we are going to do the question number 2. And okay, the teacher, a teacher. See, all these nouns are having a. That means they all are in singular number. So what we are, you can see in column B, all the verbs, all the action words are having s at their end. So a teacher teaches, a dancer dances, a chauffeur drives, a painter paints, a chef cook, a tailor stitches, a doctor treats, a farmer flock. See, I thought it's little bit messy, so one by one we are going to do it. So a teacher teaches, a dancer dances. Okay, now next is chauffeur drives, painter paints, a chef used to cook, a tailor used to stitch, a doctor used to treat, and a farmer used to plow the field. Of course, now number 3, what you have to do, we have to circle the action words among the words written in these 3 columns. So the first one, there is tree, ground and climb. What will be the action word? Climb. Second is play, dog, catch. The 2 words, that is play and catch, both are action words. So just circle it. The next is swim, cut, knife. Swim and cut, both are your verbs. Next is draw, bread and run. Again, the draw and run, both are your action words. So I'm giving just pointing the verbs. Dotted sections will be your action words. So now fly, swim, draw, cut, run. Some way you can use hit also, but generally it is, hit could be a verb, of course it could be a. Now worksheet 2, I have given the students as your homework. So it is your homework. Now I will explain you what you have to do in the worksheet number 2. I can see there are, the body parts are mentioned. Now one function which is performed from that particular part is already written. For example, your hands, you can write. Now except writing what you are doing with your hands, you should mention it in your practice book. So this will be your homework. And number 2, you have to find out at least 10 action words from this verb grid. So this will be a home assignment for today, and bye bye for now.